Welcome to another part of the Chuki Avatar installation guide. This part mostly involves coloring your Chuki by editing the material file. You'll need some sort of image editing software, such as Photoshop or Clip Studio Paint. If you have a Chuki texture file from version 1.3.1 or earlier, you can upgrade it to be used with version 1.4 or later. There's just a couple of edits you need to make, which we'll walk you through right now. If you're starting from scratch, feel free to skip this section. Use the lasso tool to select your entire neck wrap section from the old texture. Make sure to turn off the resources layer if you used it to help you find that section now. Then go to edit and select copy merged, then edit and paste. This will paste the merged neck wrap onto one new layer, merged together, so we can move it as we please. It might help to name the layer appropriately, and if you're clumsy like me, move it outside of the resources folder. With the layer selected, press Ctrl and T to enter transform mode, and then move it down by exactly 29 pixels. There are a few ways to do this, but I just press the down arrow on my keyboard 29 times, and then the return key. Magic. Finally, erase any part of the new neck wrap layer that clips with the torso layer to the right. To get the new additions from the new texture file versions, you'll want to open the asymmetrical version of those files. Then, locate and select the additions folder on the right, and press Ctrl C to copy it. Finally, head back to your original texture file, press Ctrl V to paste it in, and now you have the new additions in your old texture file. This concludes the upgrade process for textures from 1.3.1 or earlier. The rest of this video will be the usual tutorial on editing a texture from scratch. Before you begin, decide whether you would like to use the symmetrical or asymmetrical material file. They each come with their own pros and cons. The asymmetrical file allows you to customize your Chuki more by making the left side and right side different. The symmetrical file, however, uses much less space so you can achieve a higher fidelity of texture. In this video, I'll be using the asymmetrical material file as an example, but feel free to use either. Start by locating your Chuki's material file. In the Assets folder, go to Chuki, My Chukis, and then the folder named after your Chuki. You should see the material right there. We're going to set the texture used by the material to be the Photoshop file we'll be editing. That means when we make any changes, we'll be able to come back and see them happen live. Click the small circle right here, and on the pop-up window, type in Edit Texture into the search bar. This will bring us the Photoshop files. Select your favorite PSD, the symmetrical or asymmetrical one, and we're good to go. If selecting the symmetrical texture turned your Chuki into a mess, go into the texture drop-down on your material and select UV1. Remember to change it back to UV0 if you ever go back to the asymmetrical texture. Now it's time to open the Edit Texture in your image editor of choice. The texture should look something like this, like the model but flattened out. Over here in the layer list, you'll see a bunch of labeled folders that each correspond to a particular area of the Chuki. The layers within these folders can be toggled on or off depending on which markings you would like to keep. Once you've made some changes, save the file and wait for it to finish saving, then go back to the Unity window and you can see them in action. By default, you can press Ctrl and U to change the color of a layer. You can adjust its hue, saturation, and brightness to your liking, and adjust the color of that layer on the Chuki. In Photoshop, you can also try out the Colorize option. Regardless of the current layer's saturation, Colorize will inject your chosen color directly. Turn on the Resources folder for a handy visual guide as to what goes where. Just don't forget to turn it off before you're done making changes. The hair guidelines are particularly useful if you want to create a nice gradient. Take note of which parts of the rectangle influence the front of the hair versus the back, or the tips versus the roots. The Resources folder has extra guide layers available in case you want to color individual strands of some of the hairstyles. If the current layer is alpha locked, and most of them are, you can paint over it to change the color without getting any paint outside of the layer's bounds. In the case of the hair though, I'm taking the gradient option. You can see how the back of the hair is slightly different from the front in terms of color. Also, this isn't a strict guideline, but most Chuki's eye color will match their crystal color. I haven't even followed that here. Once you're happy, we don't want to go uploading a PSD to VRChat, so we'll want to make sure we have a PNG as the final texture file. Export it as normal from your image editor of choice and save it as body.png to a location you'll remember. Then, use that body.png to replace the file of the same name in your Chuki's personal folder. You'll see the texture's appearance update after a moment in the Unity window. At this point, you can select the material in that folder and replace the texture with the body.png you just copied across. Much better than uploading a PSD file. That's all for now. Congratulations! The next part of this tutorial will cover how to upload the avatar to VRChat, just in case you haven't done this before. Maybe I'll see you there, but either way, have a lovely day.